Let me show you one document first. So I hope you can see this document. This is just a sample. So let me look for another format first. Nataka tuanzie na format rahisi kwanza. So leo nataka kuwafundisha how to reference your work once umenini. So kidogo tu. So I hope you can see this document. So this is an example of an essay. So I want to show you this part. This part imeandikwa. Wacha niwatumie hii document. So utawatumia kwa WhatsApp muaccess haraka haraka alafu you open it and then tuone we go through it together. So let me send you via WhatsApp. So open it. When you receive, just open it. How many have opened that document? Initially, kwa mkono so that we can go forward. So our Stanley, who else? Sawasawa, who else? Sawasawa, if you have opened that document, najua kuna wenye wamekuja late sasa and we already started some things. So leo nataka we talk about referencing. So after you write all your work, lazima una reference. Reference mean you recognize the source that you have gotten your information from. I'm not going to talk about the structure of the paper today because I want us to go systematically. Nataka niwaonyeshe kutumia the tools first. Then after we are done with these tools, zote pamoja, now we can go to the actual paper format, type of this referencing method. So today I just want to show you how to reference us in this lesson. So as you can see that paper from the top, when you wamefungua, those that have their referencing their laptops today, you can see first we have the title page of that paper, and then in page two we have, you can see the numbering there, we have page two, title of page two, we have a letterhead there, types, terms and models of trust in an organization. So we have an introduction, so that is an introduction. We have a subheading. You can see there are ways that they have been organized. So don't worry about that. That one ndakuja baadaye. I will show you how easy unaweka hii heading where it's supposed to be for all those different writing formats. We have APA, we have Chicago, we have Harvard, we have a lot of writing styles, but the most common is APA and MLA and Chicago. So I will teach you those three first. So first you ignore the heading first. You ignore the introduction. You go all the way down to the referencing page. Hapo chini kabisa. You go to that referencing page. So some of you when wamefika hapo you'd wonder hizo vitu zimetoka wapi, hizo vitu zote nimeandika hivyo, mbona zinakaa hivyo, mbona zingine ziko na majina huko ndani, why do they have a pp sijui something and something. So hii referencing, I will show you today the tool that we use to reference our work. So after umeandika, you must recognize the author. Unaweza kwa hii reference ya kwanza imeandikwa Fulmer C and Gerard, and those are the names of a person. At what level we trust that is a journal. PP page number 167 to 1230. So if you go to that journal, you'll find that information in that page available at HTTPS. That is a DOI. So DOI is the link. So ule mtu mwenye utatumia hii work, if they want to know where you got that information, they will use that link in ikona DOI. So you'd see that structure of a reference ni vitu zimeekwa hapo na the writer now, the work now, maybe that will be doing now. But to show where you have gotten that information, lazima uweze kujua how you are going to structure this reference and how mtu mwenye umemfanyia kazi, how will they access that work. So don't worry if you don't understand for today. I want to just for you to familiarize. My teaching method is rather specific. So I try to focus on just we generalize everything, and then we come back now to the detail later. Pole pole, because now utakuwa nimekuzia rumors kidogo. So when we come back here to do this again next time, utakuwa at least sasa uko ready and you know what we are doing. So this is the reference page. You can see reference iko hapa hivi katikati. You can see venye hizi zimepangwa, there are some words zenye zimewekwa huko, ziko indented. Utapata they have followed a specific, if you look at F and K and L and M and M, you'll see that they have some they arranged somehow in an alphabetical way according to the writing format. So how we reference this work, tunatumianga kitu moja kwanza. So we go to your Google Chrome kwanza, cross that, minimize that window, tuende kwa Chrome kwanza, Google Chrome. Hapa you add a tab. Oh, okay, ask that question, Yusuf Bishal. You can unmute and then ask. Siko nimeona. You have a question?
No, I don't have a question. I just wanted to tell you that I opened the document.
Okay, well, you have opened the document, eh?
Yeah.
Sawa. So umefika hapo kwa referencing?
Yes.
Okay, so wenda kwa Google Chrome hapa, usearch Google Scholar. So hizi vitu zisikushtue for today. Once we start now with the serious classes, hapo ndio tuta hii link Google Scholar. Peter, can you send them this link for Google Scholar? Ile italeta hii nini hii hivyo.
Okay, I'm sharing it.
Nani mwenye ameweza kufungua inakaa hivyo, imeleta hivyo? By show of hand. Sawa. Wells, Purity, sawa. Hana Kibunja, sawa. Corinne, sawa. Umeweza kufungua that link hivyo, imeandikwa Google Scholar. So Google Scholar venye tu ina sound, hawa ni maskola wa Google wenye wana scholars. Mtu mwenye ameenda akaandika a research paper, they have published it in Google Scholar. So I want you to show you how we cite someone's work. We have this document here, and we have this Google Scholar here. Kuja hapa, open a new Word document. equal new Microsoft Word document, blank. Are we going together? Nikienda raka sana mniambie. Umefungua blank document. How many have that blank document? Awasawa. Mm-hmm. Okay. So don't worry. We are going to come back to these things. Eh? So na unataka tu niwapatie ile view of what we do. So that when we come to details polepole, tutaenda polepole. So uko na that black document umefungua Google Scholar hapa. So the paper that we are going to use now to cite ni paper ya trust. Yeah, e-trust. So you kuche kwa hii paper. I want us to search for something and the first page. Enda huku juu kabisa. We want to cite this work now. Enda huku juu kabisa. I want us to search the same thing. Kuja copy these terms. Just copy paste this. Copy like that. Eh? Copy. And then kuja kwa Google Scholar, you paste here. And then you search. How many have done that? Okay, so Nicodemus. At least make sure I want people to watumie laptop yao kabisa. Make sure you staki mtu akue na kalamu, staki mtu atumie Bible and a book. I don't want people to write. I want them to write kwa laptop yao, because the more you familiarize yourself with your laptop, that is how you'll get ukuko na speed, and then you'll be able to do these things very fast. So that when now we come to the serious classes, and sasa tutakuwa very serious, tutakuwa tunaenda pole pole, and I want you people to be really interactive. Eh? Mkuwe somewhere ready where if I tell you to unmute your audio, tunaweza sikizana vizuri, and then so that we can go forward. And in the future, I'll also look forward to make a video so that I can be able to appeal to your emotions, niwafundishe kitu pole pole, tukiendelea. So, tumesearch hii term. So, vitu zenye unaona hapa, kwa hiyo, tuende kwa Google Scholar, you can just listen, fungua Google Scholar so that you can listen, so that you can go together. So, ukifungua Google Scholar, unaona what is trust. So, hapa inakuja inasema, cited by 449 people, cited by 1399 people, cited by 444 people, cited by 444 people, cited by 16 people, cited by 137. In yours it might be different, but is it the same na yangu? Ebu kama mnana inakaa yangu na kama yangu zinafanana? Raise your hand kama zinafanana yangu. It might be different. So zinafanana sawa. So hiyo ndio, these are the results zenye umepata. So meaning, what is trust? A conceptual analysis of and in an interdisciplinary model. That paper, it is a research paper that somebody wrote, akapublish online. So what when you wamekuja hapa wakasite that work ni 457 people. So ni kumaanisha those people have recognized that someone's work. So we post there. Kwanza, I want you to analyze hiyo ufikirie, what have I said? Mtu ameenda akaandika paper yake, that is a publisher or an academician, akakuja akapost hiyo kitu kwa pale kwa Google. Google kachukua hiyo content because it is an original content, ikailangi vizuri sana. And now, because this is a Google Scholar, scholar mean watu wanasoma, so this is where we come to get information. Ukitumia ChatGPT, information inakuja kutoa hapa, but you must still cite this work. So, umeona hiyo. So, nataka ufungue tab ingine. So now this is the tool. Inaitangwa CiteFast.com. Unaiona CiteFast.com. CiteFast.com. Open your link. Peter unaweza tumia your link bado. CiteFast.com. 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 How many have that? Wamefungua hiyo site APA citation generator. Mnaona tu venye iko pale CiteFast. CiteFast.com. APA 7 citation generator. Nani ako na hiyo? Aya, harakisheni mpate hiyo link. CiteFast.com. Nikikuacha nyuma unaongea. CiteFast.com. How many have it by a show of hand? Who else? How many more? We have 5 people who have Nani yako na hiyo? Inaonyeshana kitu kama hiyo. Kitu kama hiyo. We have the web page, we have the book, we have the journal, we have other. Web page, book, journal, and other. So we have that. Majority of us. Is there anyone with a challenge of getting that? But don't worry if you are left behind. As long as these links are there, you'll practice polepole, and then when we meet again, maybe yes, and tunaanza kufanya sasa the actual writing, you'll be in a position to follow that very well. So you have that, so we can go forward. So tumekuja hapa, so we have Google Scholar, that is where we have searched our paper, and we have APA. This is now the tool, another tool that now we are going to train you today how to use that tool. So unaona hapa, hapa inasema enter URL. Hiyo ni web page, book, kuna journal and kuna other. So hapa unaona APA 7, APA 6, MLA 8, Chicago. So hizi vitu nitakuja kuonyesha baadaye what they are, but now I want you just ukue tu na a brief idea of what we are. Ni kama tu venye unenanga ukitaka kwenda Mombasa, kwanza unenanga kwa internet, you first search that places, una search Diani, una search huko Mpeketoni, you search everywhere, so that when you go unapata ukiwa na the idea of wherever you are going. So what I'm doing today na venye nilifanya jana, I'm just showing you a brief an overview of whatever we'll be doing in the future. So you have Google Scholar. We have searched this thing from our paper yenye nimewatumia, and we have the APA citation generator yenye iko na citing. So unakuja hapa, enda hapo kwa hiyo Google Scholar. So Google Scholar unaona hiyo option ya kusite. Cite. Finya hapo kwa kusite. Ukifinya kwa kusite, site haraka haraka, finyeni hiyo kitu kwa kusite just once, au kwenye kuna tu, is it, do we call them quotation marks? So tunataka leo tutumie kusite, we want to use APA. We want to cite using APA. So wachana MLA, wachana Chicago, wachana Harvard, and wachana Vancouver. So first we use APA. Kuja hapo kwa APA, ufinye hivyo, ita highlight yote, just click once, ita highlight yote, and then you copy. Ukikopi, kuja hapa kwa APA 7, first, kwanza before you paste, I have copied that thing, but if una copy hapa, umeitoa hapa kwa Google Scholar, then you must first determine, hiyo umeitoa wapi. Anything unatoa kwa Google Scholar, ukikuja hapa kwa APA 7 citation, unatumia option ya book ama web page to get the result. So first of all, we are going to use the, not the web page, sorry, the book and the journal. So ukuja uklik kwa journal, and then you paste that thing here yenye tumetoa kwa Google Scholar. You paste and then you search. You paste and then you search. So are we there? Nataka kuna mwenye amefika hapo kwenye nimefika. Raise your hands if you have that. If you may paste your citation kwa nini? Kwa APA 7. How many have pasted there? Please to harakisha so that we save time. And I want you to really practice these things at the end of the day. Especially so that you'll be able to paste there.
Okay, how will you know if it's from a book or journal or a web?
You nimekuambia ukitoa kwa nini kwa web, I will come to show you later. If you umetoa kwa Google Scholar,
okay,
you first use the journal. We make sure we capture zile journals ziko na hiyo information, but we first use the journal. If the journal does not bring result, use the book.
Okay.
So you first use the journal first, and I want you people to be interactive like Yusuf. So if you ask me questions, it will be better, and then since sitaboeka sana, I'll have people to respond to, nisiongee peke yangu sana. So Stanley, kindly repeat sawa sawa. And then uonge, so tumesema, tulianza hapa, hapa kwa hii document, yani watumia kwa, kwa group, tukasema we want to cite this document, we are, today we are learning citations. Citation is recognizing other person work. Mimi, my name is Edwin Kariyoki, tuseme nimeandika kitabu about Kenyan politics, nimeandika kitabu pale nimemaliza, and then now wewe ni student, unafanya history, you are writing your exams, unakuja kutumia kitabu yangu to do your exam, so umekuja, you have copied some content there, you need to cite me, because I cannot sue you, niseme you used my book against my wish. So that is why utakuja kunicite me as me now as Edwin. Recognize in your paper this information, it was not yours original. Ulikuja ukatumia information yangu. So tumesema this paper, it is about terms and models of trust in an organization. So you copy this. Ukikopi hiyo unakuja kwa Google Scholar. Google Scholar, the link is there. Google Scholar. So it is kutanza serious classes, eh? We will limit mtu mwenye ata login kama hana laptop, hatutakuwa tunaingia na yeye, because we don't want to waste your money, because I want you to get the value of whatever you are paying for. So next time ile time tutaanza now serious classes, I will make sure everybody has a laptop, mnaongea, and then we have an interactive session. So unakuja kwa Google Scholar, you search googlescholar.com, the link is there kwa hiyo chat. Unakuja una paste hiyo types and terms hapa, and then you search, na hii nini hapa inakuleta hapa. If it brings you here now, kwa hii, unakuja unafinya site hapo. Ukifinya site inakuletea a lot of things, na unaona hapa hii ni APA7. So you just click once, in a highlight blue. You just copy, unakuja hapa kwa APA7 generator, unakuja una select journal, this journal, you paste here and then you search, na imekuletea results. So I hope laptop yako iko hapo sisi wote. It might not show the same information, but assuming you are the one that had written this paper, that had written yenye nimewatumia yenye tunataka kusite nayo, mtakuwa mmeona jumi niliandika, so I know what I wrote. So if you read these results zenye zimetokea hapa, you'll be able to relate the best results that yenye imekuja kwa ile kwa hizi results yenye sasa uliandika. You'll be able to read and then you'll see hii kitu nimeitumia kwa hiyo paper, so inaweza kuwa nini muhimu. So ukitaremka hapa kabisa, mimi naona initial trust formation in new organization relationships, so me I'll use that here 1998 ama it academic writing. Also make sure unaangalia ile citation iko na latest year, kama hii ni 1998 na kuna ingine hapo ya 206. So you can just press any for demonstration purposes, but mimi nitatumia ya 206 hii kwa hapa yangu ininiletea hivyo. So nikisema hapo afu nitasema save citation, just pick one for just demonstration, useme save citation, alafu itasema ina load citation. So nani ameweza ku load citation? Unaweza niuliza swali Hana, if you have a question. Just unmute and ask. And if you may have generate your, please. Uh-huh, ask.
I'm okay. I've loaded the okay? Yeah.
You have it, eh?
Yes.
Aya, sasa. Nani ya kona hiyo yenye ame generate? Who has it? Show me by mkono hivyo. Ujua tunaenda po. Yes, Purity. Vishal, Hana. Who else? Engineer uko wapi? Agwego, Ethawa, Collins, mwingine. Engineer sawa, iko sawa. Who else? Sawa sawa. So tunaenda na wao wenye wamesema wamepata. So you have that one, eh? Umesite hapo na ndio hiyo sasa. Haya, tuende kwa nini? Tuende kwa ile document, this document, eh? Let's go to another thing. Just scroll down to that document. So definition and delimitation of the term trust. Copy hiyo. So hapa tunaenda haraka haraka, you copy. Tuende kwa Google Scholar haraka haraka. I want to see who will finish first kwa Google Scholar. It is about speed, eh? Google Scholar first. Before uende upaste hapa, uende kwa Google Scholar. Google Scholar. Usipaste pale direct kwa nini, kwa APA 7 generator. upaste hapa kwa nini, you search, itakuletea hii yenye haina citations. Hapa tunaendelea kwanza, unaangalia yenye iko cited na some other people. You just find something that has been cited. Kama one result, unakuja hapa unatoa determination, definition of the term trust. Search your definition of the term trust, edit pale kwa nini. So a general definition of the term trust. So you search for definition of the term trust, and then unakuja hapa unatumia APA you cite, you copy. Tunaenda haraka haraka, alafu tukifika pale mwisho tuone. Unakuja hapa, you select journal, and then you control V, you paste there, and then you search here. Haya, mwenye kuna mimi hapa ni kama ameshajua hata writing mapema. You just pick one, just pick one for today, then next time nitaonyesha how you pick the most relevant, you save. So unataka mwenye sasa, you raise your hand if uko na two, haraka aje purity. Mwenye akona two nini, two citations. Who have two? Sawa Bishal, who have two? Tuendelee. Hana umeacho nyuma kidogo. You have it. So at first it might sound like rocket science. It is not rocket science. It ni kitu kidogo kidogo. Who else have it? Nani amekwama? Pitasa ni sawa, hana uko nayo. Nani amekwama? Collins, uko sawa? Nicodemus, tuko wapi? Sawa, ni sawa niko. Collins, reliable writer. How reliable are you? Umefika leo hapa? Umemaliza, umepata hiyo? Stanley, uko sawa? Haya ni sawa. Hata mwenye hana laptop una follow, these things will come to repeat them. So I'm just giving you a very quick demonstration ya venye hii ni kama tu nawapatia just a general overview. So ukuja hapa kwa hiyo yenye umekopi. Alafu ukikuja hapa sasa unasema copy and paste. Unaona copy and paste hapa. Copy and paste. Itakuletea hapa select all. You select all. Select all. Hivo. And then copy. Hivo. Kuja kwa your Word document. And paste. Secret ni, don't touch this control plus. Usiguze yaka kitu kwa hapa. Itaharibu format. Usiguze hii control plus. Ika kitu kwa method muka hapa. Let me show you. Nikiguza hiyo. Unaona venye inaziweka inaharibu. So don't touch that thing. Mimi nitaenda back. Ni paste tena. Hivo. Usiguze hii control plus something. Just leave it there. I hope your word document zimefanya the same. Nani amepaste na yake inaonekana kama yangu. Haya mwingine. If you are, na usiguze, usishike anywhere, just ikae tu hivyo. Nani mwingine? Sawa, let's go. Bishal yako iko fiti?
Yes, sawa. Yes.
Aya, tuendele. Collins. James. Does yours look like mine? If not, sawa. If you are left behind, you can always ask me. Sawa. So, tuenda kwa hiyo Word document wenye wame paste. So, we are talking about citations. So, this is the most trickiest part. Yenye tumefanya hapo, anybody can do it. So, kuna rules za citation. Number one, if you go to this document, can you go to this document? This one, ya trust, enda pale chini kabisa. And leave it there. Evo reference. Ufungue hii ingine hapa bado. So we are all there. So one thing with the reference, reference apple, it must be bold. Rule number one, bold, bold. Ukitumia mtu kazi na ukitumia client kazi na ujaeka bold, anaza kurudishio kazi just because of that one bold. Because it is a common APA rule, the heading of the reference must be bold. You see at nini, see at ni we are bargaining, it must be bold. We'll come again and learn vitu zingine zinaitango how to follow instructions, because ukienda kwa nini kwa academic writing, the clients give you some instructions, anakuambia utatumia APA, kama this is citation format for APA, anakuambia we'll use Chicago, we'll use Vancouver, we'll use Harvard. So I'm just demonstrating to you today using APA citation method. So ukiangalia hapa kwa nini kwa hapa hivi, people that use Word, we know we have font and font size. So for APA, in most cases, like 90% of the cases, they would want their font size to be 12 and type to be New Times Roman. So Control A, unakuja hapa unaeka Times New Roman, alafu unaeka 12. So kwanza unaangalia mambo ya reference inakuwa bold, alafu kama client hajakuambia uweke instructions, unaweka Times New Roman. Times New Roman. Times New Roman. Reference Times New Roman. Hizo nataka mushike. So hizo nitawatumia to notes kidogo kidogo. I will send you those notes so that you can be able to recap pole 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 pole. So reference iko bold, wana niende hapa kwa nini kwa committing tena. Kila mtu reference yake iko bold. Unmute useme ni sawa, iko sawa. Unmute nisema ama unionyesha mwa mkono, sema it's okay. Is it bold? Sawa sawa, it's bold. Na iko hivyo. Haya sawa sawa, I will sample those two. If it is bold, let's go to this document. So reference iko it should be also bold, eh? Alafu kuna hizi vitu zaitangwa nini za kuweka hizi. Unaona hizi? It should be centered. Centered. Si uko mwisho na si hapo na si hapo. It should be centered. Katikati. Unatumia this just to make sure it is centered. It should be centered, number one. Yani kuja niandike hapo. Centered. It should be bold. I don't know. It should be bold, Times New Roman. Msiandike tu hizi, ndawatumia tu notes tukienda kwa hizo za ukweli. So inakuanga hivyo. So haya, hizo ni three things zenye inafaa ikue. So if you come to this now, I want you to analyze to just tell you what this citation means. Unajua unaweza iangalia uone ni kitu complicated. No, it is not complicated. We have the name of the other, huyu na huyu. Huyu na huyu na huyu. Sawa? Na huyu. Huyu ni other, huyu ni other, huyu ni other. The name of that article yenye tumepata hiyo ni organizational trust. Unaona hapa iko na imewekwa hii inaitango, what do we call this? Hiyo what do we call that thing?
Italic.
Eh, hey, italized, eh? Unaona hapa iko italized. This one is italized. Sio mimi nimeka italized, nimetoka huko kwa citation generator ikiwa hivyo, it is italized, eh? Hata hiyo unaona ni italized. We have the DOI. If you copy this DOI, this one, eh? And in most cases, eh, ukitumia client kazi, you just hyperlink. Hyperlink it, eh? Unakuja hapa hyperlink iko wapi? Nataka ku hyperlink. So put one kama ndaweza ku hyperlink. It should be hyperlinked. Hyperlink, hyperlink. Dogo tu. Unakuja hapo, nataka ikuwe blue. Hyperlink. Okay. Hizo vitu ujifunze pole pole, ujifunze tu pole pole. Una select hivyo hivyo. hiyo HTTPS, unakuja hapa una kwanza you first remove the hyperlink kwanza, kama inakataa kukuletea option ya hyperlink, alafu unakuja you hyperlink now, hyperlink. So when the clients now come, akitaka kujua where you got that information, they cannot always access that information via these links. Are we together up to that point? Hyperlinking, are you together? Oh, tuko sawa, 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 Stanley. Are you together up to that point? You make sure you hyperlink. Now, it is not a requirement, but just to, you know, whatever you are doing, make sure that that thing is hyperlinked. So we are referencing, eh? So we hyperlink that one. So centered, bold, Times New Roman 12. So another thing that unafaa uangalie sana, you come and copy-paste all these things like that. Fanya hivyo, copy-paste. Just listen to my voice when they will copy-paste your kila, copy your kila kitu, just copy your kila kitu yote. Listen to my voice. So I'm assuming kila mtu amecopy hivyo. Ukicopy hivyo, unakuja hapa una nini? Unaweka kitu wako hapa? Angalia hako. Open that kathing. Can you see this kathing? Kaado yuko hapa, kando hapa. Iyo. Iyo. Ako. Unakashika hako kaado. Unakuja hapa. Line spacing. Hapa special hapa. Unaweka hanging. Hanging, hanging. Line spacing, unakuja unaweka double. Hanging, double. Hanging, double. Unasema okay. Utapata imechange kitu, hata kama uta notice, but it has changed something. So unakuja kwa hii corner hii. Hanging. Unakuja unaweka double. Unakuja hanging, let me repeat myself again, cancel. Unakuja hii hapa kwa kakona anka. Unasema hanging. Unaweka double. And then unasema okay. So you'll find, kuna something imefanya. You cannot see it, but imearrange. So, hiyo ndiyo APA citation, and that is how it works. So I hope everybody is clear up to that point. Show me na mkono mwenye amefanya hivyo, ameweza kuguza kwa kitu ikasema hanging na double hivyo hivyo. Mwingine? Mwingine? Sawa, sawa. I can see some majority of hands there, watu wenye wana follow. So that is how tunafanyanga kitu inaitangwa citation of APA. Kuna we have APA 6 and APA 7. We'll come again and touch about the similarities and differences, but that is how we generally cite. Hata sasa ukienda kwa class yako sasa, ukienda pale kwa ChatGPT, ukiguza vitu zako pale, uwekee lecture pale, umsaitie, atashtuka sana, atakuwa scared. Hata in fact, he might even faint, that lecturer. Yu watashangaa ujamaa hizi vitu walijulia wapi. But now, if you are doing an academic research for a person, akuambia umsaitie with APA, APA 7, APA 6, that is how we do it. So that is just a general way of doing it. So we will come back to these things. Pole pole. Tuanze pale kwa title. Tukuje pale kwa body. Where are we supposed to put that conclusion? Where are we supposed to put that introduction? What is a thesis statement? These vitu they might sound as if they are rocket science, but ukijitrain kidogo kidogo hivi kidogo kidogo utapata hata yani. They are very easy for you. Just usitumie kalamu kuandika kitu, just make sure you use your laptop. Hizo links zenye zote umetumia hapo, make sure umeitumia na ChatGPT, look for something, peleka pale kwa state writer, rewrite it, peleka pale kwa paraphrasing tool, paraphrase it, peleka pale kwa grammarly, remove those errors pole pole, so that when we come now again, tutaweza kuenda pole pole, and as we are progressing forward. So guys, that was it for today. I can see my time is up already. So I hope today you have learned something. When you walikuwa jana najua na wamekuja tena leo, I know at least you have a lot. Unajua umasoma kitu kubwa sana, at least now unajua whatever we are doing now, it's something that in a make sense. Sibahatishi, whatever I'm teaching you, I know what I'm doing. And I will make sure I teach you on the most important thing that you'll use market. So,
okay.
No, you cannot. Maybe... Wait, just one moment. Kuna mtu unasema hapo, anauliza, can you cite and reference from ChatGPT? Ukiambia ikusaitie, it will do that. Ukimaliza pale kazi, like let me show you. ChatGPT. Unaambia what is trust. Alafu unaambia and please cite. ChatGPT ni mwelevu sana, inajua kila kitu. So, unaona hapa imekuletea citations.
Yeah, just okay. One, maybe let me mention on that, Edwin.
Yeah.
As much as it will cite, I would like to request that you confirm, because sometimes it can cite its own things, especially when there are some issues. So if you get a citation from ChatGPT, make sure you confirm. You don't take it 100%. So confirm as you have been shown. So that now you are sure 100% that whatever it has said to you there is correct. So it's always good to confirm.
Okay, on my own personal opinion, ChatGPT, when it comes to citation, just avoid it. Kimbia mbio, leave it. Kama ni moto ya kuwata moto. Because you can see kama hii, haina DOI. So how will the client access that link of whatever that you have done? So ChatGPT citation is wrong. Kabisa, it is totally wrong. Don't use it. Not unless you ile kazi unafanya, it is not that serious. Yani si kazi naangaliwa sana, but if ni kazi ya mtu, unafanya, you can always cite with it. But if it is a formal writing, avoid using ChatGPT because it will leave out some things that are maybe unnecessary. Unajua, hizi vitu kuna systems that they check. Hizi accounts za unasikina za academic rating, utaenda upload pale kazi uki submit. Kuna system pale inaangalia whatever you have done. Kama citations iko sawa, kama heading iko sawa, kama spacing iko sawa. And if that work is not good, hata kama niyo bolding, they will still return that work to you. Wakawambia please bold that work. So, ili avoid hizo vitu zote, just make sure you follow the instructions. Kwa citations, that's why nimekuwa nikikuwa more keen nayo. Tulifanya mara mingi so that kila mtu elewe about that citation. I think, Peter, that is it for me today. Maybe if you want to add something, if somebody has a comment, we can go forward from there.
Okay, I can see only you are requesting that you want to know whether you will share the link. Yeah, the link will be there. We are going to upload the video on our YouTube channel. Kindly make sure you subscribe also. And one thing you should note, our agreement was that we are going, first of all, to give you like free access to the classes. And then we are expecting that after this, now you can start to commit in terms of paying for the amount we had agreed. So we are going to expect that from maybe the next session, you should have made some commitment if you are willing to continue with these classes. So that is it for now. And again, another thing is, as Mr. Edwin is saying, I think you should just concentrate on the class as he is teaching. We are going to give you like the theory part of it, of which now it's just good to know, but the practical thing is what is important, because that is what you'll be doing day in, day out. So don't, the moment you don't understand, don't let it slide, because it's each and every session is building on the previous one. So if you don't understand one section, it might interfere now with the next. So kindly ask as many questions as possible. And if you don't understand, make sure you it is explained back away. So that is it. And I don't think there's something else today. That is the end of the session. So you will get this link afterwards. But in case you have any question or parting shot or comment, maybe you can raise your hand before we end this today's session.
You can look at the message center. People have sent messages there.
Oh, okay. Yeah, thanks for it. It has been an indicative class. What is the amount? So we are charging at a discount. We are charging just 5,000 for the whole session for the next 4 weeks, this week, next week, and the other 2 weeks. So we are charging 5,000. We expect that now you can make your commitment in terms of the amount you can be able to raise, and then we can be able to agree on how maybe you'll be paying the full fee. If you have the total amount, you're going to share our pay bill as well as the account number, and afterwards that's what you're going to use to pay. The other one is Michelle, thank you. And okay, I think I have answered that. So kuna swali nyingine yoyote? Okay. Now another thing is our classes. I think hata naona kuna mtu anajoin saa hii. Acha nimuadmite nimwambie. So our classes start exactly at 8. We try to limit in terms of time so that now we don't extend. Kama saa hii inafaa kuwa tumefunga. So our classes start exactly at 8. So I'll be sharing the link before 8. So kindly set some time aside. Then you can join early so that we can finish early, because sometimes we have extended because people are late to join. So kindly from 8 to 9 so that we can have a Q&A session maybe from 9 to around 9:15 to 9:30 there. So we start at 8. I'll be sharing the link on the group. So thank you very much for coming, and we look forward to the next session. And at the end of the day,
before you close,
okay, just go.
Before you close, nimeona nini, nimeona, I wish kila mtu hapa akona laptop, because mimi sitaki kuwadanganya you can run this thing with a phone. Takuwa tu na waste your resources. Hakuna jani, because with phone you'll never be able to make sure you follow whatever we are doing. So I would advise, as we log into the next class, strictly watch ikuwe laptop. Next time people don't musishai off, I want to see you asking those questions. Nataka zikuje kabisa, so that by the end of hizo 3 weeks, first 3 weeks, kila mtu wakua amejua, hiyo wiki ingine tu ni kurefresh, so that I can get time to show you several ways that we get clients online, how to pitch for proposals, where do you get these people, which are the best academic writing accounts that you'll buy. But I don't advise new students to buy those accounts, because utanunua and then you'll make mistakes and then your account will be suspended. So I want to teach you how to go to several platforms, and clients are there and they're also looking for people. People are lucky, kuna watu wanaingianga hapo wanaomoka, wengine wanabahatika, wanaenda wanapata, wanapewa kazi na wengine, people other wananunua accounts. So it's a very big industry, because we're also going to teach about articles also, apart from academic writing. So I would really wish mkuwe na laptops, na if atuwa unaona kitu saizi kuelewi, you will figure it out pole pole until it sticks to your mind. Yes, you can ask a question, Yusuf.
Okay, I wanted to ask, are the classes every night or the specific nights?
Monday to Friday, utapata link, unaingia. Monday to Friday, hii masaa ya kutoka 8 to 9:30. Saa zingine mkisema tuweke 9, tunaezaweka. Mimi ya mbevila, mnujua mtu academic rating hata lalangi, because tunasemanga, as long as watu wa US wameamka, you don't sleep. That is the principle of academic rating. Saa hizi US ni saa 8 na dakika 33. So if those people are awake, why should you be sleeping, and that is where daughter come from?
Okay.
So mimi mchana nimelala, saa hizi mimi niko matata, ukinitext saa 9 na nusu I still reply. Ukiona sija reply, ujue niko na mrembo wangu mahali. So that is it for today, guys. You'll have a good night. And Peter, maybe you can close, alafu tupatane kesho. Bye bye.
Okay, thank you very much, Edwin. So I think we are cruising on nicely. So see you tomorrow, guys. Same time, same place. The link will be there. We start from 8. So kuena John Njema, and have yourself a good night.
Bye, guys.